Welcome back for another video. Before we begin this video though, I just want to let y'all know, Barrio Tales hoodies are now available. Red, black, purple, orange, and blue. Cash App and PayPal, how you can reach me. They're only $25 with free shipping. Don't just look at it, wear it. T-shirts are also available still. All you gotta do is hit that Cash App and PayPal that you see right there. Thank you. Welcome back for another video. Today's video will be about beef and real life incidents involving two hoods, Lomas and the La Sangra gang, both located in the San Gabriel Valley. A Lomas gang member by the name of Luis Rodriguez had made his presence known with Lomas and Sangra, but not what you think. Allow me to elaborate. Luis was recruited into the gang's most vicious clique, Lomas Locos. These were the hardcore members of Lomas, the ones who did the shootings and other heinous crimes. Luis left the Lomas gang after some of his angered homeboys shot at him because he had been trying to establish a truce between Lomas and his chief rival, Sangra. So that says a lot about Lomas. Moving on now. On Sunday, March 7th, 1993, Lomas gang member Salvador Lopez, 15-year-old of Rosemead, who was shot and killed in a drive-by shooting in front of his home in the 1600 block of Del Mar Avenue. Less than 12 hours later, Lomas gang members seeked revenge. At 1 p.m. the same day, nine youths playing basketball at McKinley Elementary School, a block east of Del Mar Avenue, were fired upon by one or two gun-wielding youths. Three people were wounded. All three were associates of the Sangra gang. 4 days later, police arrested Santos Gonzalez, an 18-year-old of South San Gabriel, an associate of the Lomas gang. That same day, two male Latinos driving the 1600 or 1700 block of Del Mar Avenue at 7:30 p.m. rolled down their windows and opened fire on a 15-year-old boy from San Gabriel who was hit in the left leg. On New Year's Eve, 1994, a group of Lomas gang members gathered at the West Covina house to celebrate the new year. Sometime before that day, Lomas gang members learned that a Sangra gang member was living in the neighborhood. Alejandro Valadez looked out the window that night and saw a young man walking the sidewalk in front of the house. The young man was wearing baggy pants, baggy shirt, and a black jacket. Although Valadez had not seen him before, he assumed that the young man was with the Sangra gang, who had been reported to be living in the neighborhood. The young man was Gregory Acuna, the victim who was not a member of the Sangra gang. Valadez yelled out to the others at the party. He expected that they would go up to him, jump him maybe. By jump, he meant to beat them up. Valadez did not intend to personally confront the man. Larry Hernandez, Victor Hernandez, and another man ran out and confronted Acuna saying, "Where are you from?" which was a question asking about Acuna's gang affiliation. Valadez walked out of the house onto the grass in front, holding his baby in his arms. Acuna was trying to walk away with the three following him. Larry Hernandez tried to pull Acuna's jacket off, and Victor Hernandez took a swing at Acuna. As Acuna tried to get away, Victor Hernandez pulled out a gun and started shooting at him. Acuna ran across the street as Victor Hernandez continued firing at him. Valadez heard a total of 4 or 5 shots. Both Larry and Victor Hernandez were tried and convicted for first-degree murder. Larry Hernandez was sentenced to 16 years to life in prison, as well as life in prison without the possibility of parole, plus 1 year. Victor Hernandez was sentenced to 38 years to life in prison. At about 1:45 p.m. on July 19, 2004, Freddie Nilo was driving an SUV in the city of San Gabriel. Christopher Gonzalez and Julian Zarate were Nilo's passengers. Nilo stopped at a stoplight. A gas station was to the left of the SUV. St. Anthony's Church was to the right. As they were stopped, Zarate saw two men on the steps of the church. Zarate saw something silver and ducked. Zarate heard gunshots coming from his right. Nilo sustained 2 gunshot wounds to his head and 1 to his left arm or wrist. Nilo died from the gunshot wound to his head, each wound being fatal. According to Zarate, no one in the car had said anything to the men, and the men had not said anything to anyone in the car. Zarate was not a gang member and did not believe that Nilo or Gonzalez was a gang member. City of San Gabriel police detectives overheard a radio call concerning the shooting and went to the scene. Detectives looked inside the SUV and did not see any weapons. They believe that there was a baseball bat in the SUV. Detectives saw between 5 and 7 shell casings in the upper area of St. Anthony's Church. The City of San Gabriel Police Department searched for 2 suspects who had fled from the scene of the shooting. As they searched, they saw 2 men who fit the description of the suspects. David Pacheco was one of the men. Officers stopped and looked at the men, and they took off running. Officers lost sight of the men and radioed dispatch that the suspects likely had gone over a retaining wall adjacent to the 10 freeway. Officers saw 2 men who matched the description of the suspects walking along the freeway. As officers' car approached the men ran. One of the men struggled to remove a gun from his waistband. Officers fired 2 shots at the suspect. Both shots missed. Eventually, City of San Gabriel police officers stopped David and held him at gunpoint until another officer arrived and took David into custody. The other suspect went into a drainage hole. A gunshot residue test was performed on hands. The test revealed 1 particle of gunshot residue. Officers took witnesses to drive by to see if they can positively identify David as a shooter for a field show-up. Zarate identified David as a shooter, and that Zarate's identification was definite. At about 9 a.m. on July 22, 2004, David had a conversation with Gilbert Padilla at the Los Angeles County Inmate Reception Center. The conversation was recorded on a compact disc that was played for the jury. In that conversation, David stated that he had been busted for killing a sad girl. Sad girl is a term used by Lomas gang members to refer to members of Sangra, a rival gang. David told Padilla that the car pulled up and an exchange ensued in which someone in the car asked, "Where you fools from?" David asked, "Where you fools from?" David then said, "This is where I'm from. What's up?" Boom, boom. David apparently, having discharged his gun, reloaded his gun. David and Shaggy ran away. David described fleeing from the police and jumping over the wall to the 10 freeway. Apparently, referring to his gun, David told Padilla that he hid the thing shortly before he was apprehended. Based on David's statement and an audio surveillance that he had placed the gun in the general area of the officer shooting, investigators and a K-9 scent dog went to that area of the 10 freeway. A Jennings 380 caliber Brico model handgun was found hidden in some shrubs. The bullets, bullet fragments, and cartridge case recovered from the scene of the shooting had been fired or ejected from the Jennings 380 caliber Brico model handgun. David Pacheco was convicted of first degree murder, 2 counts of attempted murder, and firearm possession as a felon. David was sentenced to 130 years to life plus 8 months.